What's up, guys? I'm going to play Quake on the Nintendo Switch. Quake with a controller. That is like, ew. No, that is like sacrilege to a real PC gamer. But I digress. That is a way to play this game on the go. I'm not playing on the go. I'm going to play it on a screen right this second. But you can play it on the go. And this is a great version of this game. A really, really, really good version. Graphics look great. And it plays great. And if that's not enough for you, then, you know, whatever. I'm going to put it just in the standard mode, but there is, like, a lot of updates and a lot of add-ons that they've done to this. So, this game supports really, really good motion controls. And this controller now, it wasn't working in Resident Evil Revelations earlier, in my previous video, but it is working on this one. Is supporting the motion controls. Motion controls in a Switch game, to me, kind of make the game control similar to a mouse and keyboard. Now, that may sound ridiculous to a person that plays preferentially with a mouse and keyboard, but to me, it kind of tries to bridge that gap. But Quake is an awesome game. Little known fact about this game, at least maybe some people, but Trent Reznor did a lot of the sound design and the music to this game. And there's even some references to him when you pick up some of the weapons and the ammo. There's these little NIN, Nine Inch Nail, logos on them that are very similar. And I think they even used some of his vocal samples. But yeah, this game when I was a kid was really, really, really adult. And I wasn't really supposed to play it, but my dad was really cool. And one thing I don't know if I've really ever talked about is how cool my dad was when it came to gaming. My dad was pivotal to my gaming as a child. Like, literally. He would always make sure that I had, like, the coolest games and game systems. I mean, I could name a lot of examples, but I was very, very fortunate. And he also would play video games. And he had a friend, I think I have talked about this maybe before, that played video games as well. And they kind of had this weird little competition about who would have the most high-tech computer, you know, to play games at the highest resolution for a while. And that was always great for me because my dad was always trying to update his system. And so me and my brother would get, like, his old parts or whatever. And so we would get, you know, new graphics cards when they would come out so he could get new graphics cards. Anyways, he was super into it, and he worked in the computer industry. So he always got, like, I think really good deals and stuff. And it was just, this is really cool, really cool times to watch, you know, graphics go from that 2D to 3D. And if you were playing games on computers, and if you were part of the computer world at that time, you saw that happen fast. If you were just playing consoles, it wasn't until, like, the PlayStation 1 came out that you really saw, like, polygonal graphics, you know, truly. You had, like, you know, PlayStation, like Super Nintendo games like Super FX and Racers and Star Fox and Vortex and things like that. Mode 7 graphics, if you will. But you didn't have, like, real 3D polygonal graphics until, you know, the 32-bit era. You know, you had things that tried to emulate that, like on the Panasonic 3DO. But it wasn't really it until the Saturn and the PlayStation came out. But the PC had games like Tomb Raider, and anyways, you know, there was 3D polygonal graphics alone in the dark way before there ever was on consoles, like true 3D environments you could explore. And obviously, id Software was one of the most important companies in that whole, you know, universe of game designers. And Quake was really an important game. It actually originally started out as something completely different. It was going to be... I remember reading about it in this, not in the instruction manual. God, you gotta take these guys out quick because they'll throw grenades at you. But I remember reading about this game before it became a 3D game. It was going to be a 2D game, a completely different game. And it eventually became what it is now because John Carmack and John Romero, you know, they really love all this dark imagery stuff, which I'm not going to say I don't. I mean, obviously I do. This is, like, super freaking cool. But they wanted to go for a different aesthetic, and they didn't want it to be exactly like Doom. But this was... Oh, shit. I'm about to die. But this was a really, really, really... I died. This was a really, really important 3D game because it was the first game that had almost, like, really polygonal characters and environments with dynamic lighting, where like there'd be lighting off of particle effects, like bullets and the lightning coming out of guns, and you know, that kind of thing, and torches in the background. And this game had, you know, complex vertical and horizontal levels that you could explore, and swimming, and it was, you know, it was really ahead of its time. It really was. I'm not just saying that. Quake was a early. That was a good frag. It was a good. That sound, I think, is my door. It scares the crap out of me. It's my outside door. But this game was really, really ahead of its time, and Quake was an early adopter of 3D graphic accelerators like the Voodoo graphics cards. That really set you aside from the people that were not serious or did not have the funds for gaming. And again, I did not have the funds for it. But my dad gave me the hand-me-downs. So I didn't have the stuff when it was brand new. But we got it eventually, and it was awesome. We played games like this and Descent, which was really, really good with really, really good graphics. And you just wanted a computer that could run this because at the time, the graphics were just so mind-blowing. They were just so good. So ahead of their time, like I was saying earlier. And you had to really learn to explore the level. Like, oh my gosh, I don't have the key. So you got to get down in here, into the water. And, you know, they didn't overcomplicate the controls. You just move around in a very, you know, well-rendered 3D space with 3D graphics and 3D controls. And everything just kind of works, you know, relatively pretty well. I really have no complaint about that. You just have to be willing to explore and take your time, and you'll find eventually everything that you're looking for, if you look for it. But right now I'm trying to find that key, which is surprising. I thought the key was in here. It really did. This door opens elsewhere. Man, I cannot remember where that key is. But anyways, that's part of the fun of the game. But yeah, this is Quake. And I'm playing Quake on the Nintendo Switch. And this was originally a PC game that came out forever ago. Like, forever ago. In the 90s. Like, can you believe that? But they've obviously updated it quite a bit. Ooh, there's that double-barrel shotgun. See, now we're getting somewhere. Like I said earlier, you just have to be willing to explore and dodge and frag and look out for traps. Because, see, now there's just some traps. Not even, like, actual, you know, enemies. They're just traps. These things are just soulless. See, ooh, these grenades really get you. Ah, those tight corridors. But yeah, this is Quake for the Nintendo Switch. Let me know what you guys think of this game in the comments below. Have you ever played Quake? Are you a fan of id Soft games? Isn't it weird that Bethesda bought them out? Isn't it cool that after you die, the enemies just kind of walk over your corpse, mumbling weird, gross stuff in the background? What was your favorite game to play back then? Am I the only, like, really old person watching this video that actually plays Quake? You can play this online with people if you want to. I don't. I don't know who would do that. But just playing the single-player version of this game is a walk down memory lane. If you want to do that, if you just happen to have a Switch laying around, I would definitely recommend playing this. This would be a solid 10 out of 10 version of Quake. So get Quake on Nintendo Switch. It's definitely worth it. And until next time, you know what we say. Bye.